Hey, it's Missy, and today's tutorial is 3 hairstyles for spring, but I think these would also be really pretty for every day, so make sure to subscribe in case you haven't yet, and let's go ahead and get started. The first hairstyle is this topsy-tail ponytail that looks tricky but is actually really easy to do. So the first step is to divide off a section of hair at the top of the head and tie it off with a clear elastic band. And for this hairstyle, you don't want it to be right in the center of the back of the head, but instead slightly off-center towards the left side. Next, create a small gap right above the elastic and flip the tail up through the gap, pulling it back down again. To make it a little more distinctive, go back and gently pull on the edges. And you don't want to do this too much or the hair can stick out kind of oddly, so just gently pull it out slightly until it looks the way you prefer. Now pick up a new section of hair right underneath the first topsy tail, and we're going to tie this together with a second elastic band, but this time it's going to be slightly off center towards the right side, and each of these will kind of go in a zigzag pattern down the back of the head. So just tie off the section, and then we're going to create a small gap right above the hairband, looping the tail up through the gap and pulling it back down again. Pull the topsy tail tight and then you can go back and gently pull on the edges. If you don't want this to be too big and full, then just pull slightly or completely skip this step. It's all up to you. Now pick up a new section of hair on the right side and the left side, and you want to kind of make sure that each topsy tail is the same thickness. So I mostly picked up hair from the sides because this is a little thinner than the bulk of the hair that's going down the center. Create a gap above the hairband and flip the tail up through the gap, creating a third topsy tail. Now just continue picking up sections of hair, creating topsy tails down the back of the head, alternating between the left side and the right side so that they create a slight zigzag pattern. Once the topsy tails reach the nape of the neck and all of the hair is brought in, you can stop and leave the style just like this. I decided to pick up 2 more sections from the ponytail and create a last topsy tail just so that it kind of comes down the length of the ponytail slightly. Once all of the topsy tails are tied, then you can go back and kind of work the shape of the hairstyle. I just went through and kind of pulled on pieces that I wanted to stick out a little bit more and smoothed down any flyaways or sections that were sticking out farther than I liked. So that is the basic technique behind this hairstyle. You can leave it like this for wearing every day. But since this is a spring-inspired hairstyle, I decided to embellish mine with a few rosebuds and flowers. These are from my local craft store, and I just slid them in sporadically using bobby pins to hold them in place. And that is the last step for this hairstyle, a really fun topsy-tail ponytail that is a lot easier to do than it looks and is perfect for every day. The second hairstyle is this lace braid and fishtail combo. With a part on the right side, pick up a section of hair near the forehead. Divide it into 3 pieces, and we're going to use this section to create a lace braid. Take the strand on the right, cross it over the middle, then take the strand on the left, cross it over the middle. Cross the strand on the right over the middle, and we're not going to bring in any hair on this side of the braid, so then cross the strand on the left over the middle, pick up a new section of hair, crossing it over the middle and adding it into the braid. Cross the strand on the right over the middle, and then the strand on the left over the middle, and pick up a new section, bringing it into the braid. Cross the strand on the right over the middle, then the strand on the left over the middle, pick up a new section, and bring it into the braid. Now that the braid has reached the ear, braid this section to the bottom in a regular braid, and tie off the end with a clear elastic band. Bring the rest of the hair over the left shoulder, and we're going to wrap the hair with the braid. So take the braid, laying it over the top, wrap it underneath and back up the front side, continuing to wrap the hair until you reach the end of the braid. Now take a clear elastic band, and we're going to tie this over the ponytail, making sure to tie the end of the braid as well, and this is what will hold the braid in place. Once it's tied off, then remove the elastic band from the end of the braid. You can leave the braid just like this, but I decided to go back and gently pull on the edges to make it a little fuller. Now with the ponytail, we're going to create a fishtail braid. Take the ponytail and split it into two equal sections. Divide off a small piece from the right side and cross it over the top, adding it into the left side. Then take a small piece from the left side, crossing it over and adding it into the right side. Take a small piece from the right, cross it over to the left. Take a small piece from the left, cross it over to the right. And this is how to create a fishtail braid. So just repeat these steps, braiding the ponytail to the bottom in a fishtail braid. Then gently go back and pull on the edges to make it fuller. Then to finish the braid, I took one small section of hair and wrapped it around the base of the braid. Took a clear elastic band, wrapping it over the ends, making sure to include the ends from the wrapped section. And then pulled the elastic band tight and the wrapped hair will cover the elastic band. And that is the last step for this hairstyle. A really cute combination side braid that is great for every day because it stays in nice and snug and won't come loose during the day. The third hairstyle is this fishtail French braid headband. So with a part on the left side, divide off a section of hair from the part down to the right ear, clipping off the back section. Pick up a small slice of hair near the part and divide it into two equal sections. Take a small piece from the left side, cross it over to the right. Then take a small piece from the right, cross it over to the left. Now begin incorporating hair into the braid. So take a small piece from the left, cross it over to the right. Pick up a new section of hair, crossing it over and adding it into the right side. Take a small piece from the right side, cross it over to the left. Pick up a new section of hair, crossing it over and adding it into the left side. Then take a small piece from the left side, cross it over to the right. Pick up a new section of hair and cross it over to the right side. Take a small piece from the right, cross it over to the left. Pick up a section, crossing it over to the left. And I kept my sections really close to the braid at the beginning and then slowly worked out to the hairline. And this is how to create that sweeping effect that you see at the end. So then take a small piece from the left, cross it over to the right. Pick up a section, crossing it over to the right. Cross a small section from the right over to the left. Pick up a new section and cross it over to the left. And you can see that I'm not picking up hair right at the hairline yet. I'm still staying close to the braid. So just continue crossing small sections over to the opposite side, picking up sections and bringing them into the braid, adding in hair until it reaches the temple, then braid the section to the bottom in a regular fishtail braid. Once the braid reaches the bottom, take a small section from the ends and then gently push the rest of the braid upwards. And this will make it a little bit easier to pull on the edges, making the braid a lot more full. So then just gently pull on the edges to kind of fix the shape, and then backcomb the ends so that they don't unravel. Now let down the hair at the back and take the braid, wrapping it around the head. Pin the braid against the head, lay a section of hair over the ends to hide it, and that is the last step. A really fun way to add an accent braid to your everyday curls. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed these three hairstyles. I would love it if you would comment below letting me know which of the three was your favorite. Make sure to click the thumbs up if you did enjoy the tutorial. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then be sure to click the subscribe button. And I'll see you next time. Bye!